sometimes I remember how I used to be living in sin. I tried to act happy and free, but I wasn't within. I fooled a lot of friends of mine. They thought I had some peace of mind, but I never had a thing until I opened up and let Jesus in. Thank you.
belong. I've always been a stranger here, but now I'm going home. No more tears,
because I've got God has never failed us yet. Cause we're saved, saved, saved. It's the only way to be. Well, now I tried the other, but Jesus is the way for me. We don't deserve the love that he shares. We don't deserve the way that he cares. I guess it's just that he loves us so, and he wants everyone to know. We shouldn't worry and we shouldn't fret, cause our God has never failed. Yet, cause we're saved, saved, saved. It's the only way to be. Well, now I try the other, but Jesus is the way for me.
Tim Johnson on the piano. And Randy Adams on bass. Rick Norris on drums. Dallas Holm on time. Now we're all having fun, and that's good. I don't want to put a damper on it, but I don't want anybody to forget or not realize the real significance of us being together here. This is an important night. Consider it. It's called the Freedom Festival, the only real freedom that there's ever been is the freedom of the soul. Jesus can give you that freedom.
Someone you love them, they may love you too. Jesus' name.
Convention.
I said, sorry, ain't got no room without a reservation. But I'm sure if I call ahead, well, I can find you a bed. But you might have to wait till morning instead. Getting late, he said, my wife's gonna have a baby today. Well, the man said, all I got to offer is a little old shack, and you can find it if you look real hard. It's out around the back. We'll chase those cattle out, move some things about. We'll see you in the morning, and don't forget to check out. Well, if he'd known baby Jesus was king, and if he'd known he created everything, I feel sure he'd found them a better place to stay.
I'm from Minnesota. Yay. And you're not. We have a thing up there we call winter. And we have something we call snow. I know you have something you call snow too, but it's not the same. I think it's the difference between inches and feet. How many of you ever got your tongue stuck on a cold piece of metal? All right. How many of you have... you have no idea whatsoever what I'm talking about. Hey, a few more of them. Let me tell you a little story. It has nothing much to do with anything, but my brother and I were over on a hill one day sliding. Now, my brother was and still is 3 years older than I am. I was just a little bitty kid. And they have a thing they call a sled. It's got little wooden slats, little metal runners, and a little wooden steering device. It looks kind of a cut-down version of Santa's sleigh, just a one-man deal. And you lay down on your belly and you go down the hill. Or if you're a little braver, you can sit down on it and go down the hill. And if you're a complete idiot, you can stand up on it and go down the hill. But you don't go very far. My brother, being much older and wiser than I, said, Dallas, next time you go down the hill, put your tongue on this piece of metal on the front of the sled. He said, you get a real neat feeling. What do I know it? My young age. So I lay down on my belly, started going down the hill. Now, for those of you who don't know, when you're in freezing or below, which we were that day, and you put your nice warm tongue on that ice-cold piece of metal, the two become as one. So there I went all the way down the hill. And that wasn't bad enough. When I got to the bottom, I had no idea whatsoever what was happening. This is the first miracle I've ever seen in my whole life. And so I rolled off the sled, stood up, walked all the way back up the hill with holding the slide with my tongue on it. My brother thinks this is the greatest thing he's ever seen. And I'm crying and, you know, panic is stricken me. What is this that's happening? My tongue is growing into the sled. So out of fear and frustration and panic, I finally just pulled it off. Ah, you got it figured out. Yes, removes many wonderful layers of skin. So, if you still don't believe that, next winter, if you get some cold weather, go find you a piece of metal. You get a real neat feeling. I can remember, I guess about March or so, when spring was supposed to be on the way, get up in the morning and open the shade, hope to see the sun shining. It wasn't. Get up the next day, today's the day, you know. Still no summer. And when you're little kids, you get kind of depressed because you get pretty anxious for the warm weather, get out and play ball and stuff. You finally just decide it's going to be winter all summer long this year. It's not coming. One morning out of habit, you open the shade, and lo and behold, the sun is shining, snow is melting, and it's a beautiful time of year. Well, I've come to realize and believe that it's the same way in life many times, and let me explain. I kind of mentioned it before, but there are people here tonight, and people who will listen to this album, and you can sit there with a smile on your face, and everybody around you would think everything's okay. Boy, I wish I could be like that. And they got no problems. Some of you, right now, you know the hurt and the burden. Some of you have prayed the prayers that never seem to get answered. You've done everything you know to do. You've prayed, you've claimed the promises, you've done it all, and still, nothing. Some of you have prayed so long you can't even remember when you started, and it doesn't seem like you're any closer to the answer now than it was when you started. There are some people that would like us to believe this should not be. Especially as Christians, every day should be great. No problems. No burdens. I disagree with that. Very strongly. My Bible says many are the afflictions of the righteous. I happen to believe that if you decide to become a Christian, a born-again believer, you're going to have, you can just write it down, you're going to have some bad days. There will be some things you don't understand. There will be some valleys. There will be some trials. That scripture goes on to say, but the Lord will deliver us out of them all. Now, I suspect some people just get impatient. You know, they look at the promise and they say, ask anything in my name and I'll do it. Now, we want to stick in this word that says now. Ask and you shall receive. Now. It doesn't say anything about now. I don't understand some things I've gone through. I don't understand why when I pray sometimes and read my Bible and try to get direction, I just don't seem to get anything at all. Now, some people come up and say, oh, it's because there's sin in your life. Well, they can judge and make that judgment if they want to. I know my heart. Jesus looks at the honesty and the intent of the heart. And he hears the cries of the heart. However much you hurt, he hurts that much more because he's touched with the feelings of our infirmities. He knows. He's never left us. He's never forsaken us. There is no such thing as an unanswered prayer. Sometimes the answer is yes, sometimes the answer is no, sometimes the answer is wait a while. But he's heard every word, he's known every thought. There is an answer. And it will not be like I thought when I was a kid, it's going to be winter all summer long. You know what? As far as I know, they've had a summer every year in Minnesota. And there is an answer for your prayer. It'll come. He knows, he understands. The snow will melt, and he'll bring it about.
Looked out the window on a cold winter's day. Wonder if summer's gonna come. Press my hand on the cold window pane. Can't feel the warmth, can't see the sun. I guess that's the way it it's always been. You gotta take the bad times with the good. The sun ain't gonna shine every day of your life, even though you think you wish it could. But even in bad times, there's some good. So I guess, unless the world stop turning, those old dark clouds gonna roll away. Snow's gonna melt, the grass gonna green. It's gonna be a bright, shiny day. I guess that's the way he's always been. The sun comes along just in time. He melts all your fear and he shines on your joy. And he always makes you feel so fine. And he's always there right on time. Ooh, I love the sun. Oh, I love you, Jesus. I love the sun. Won't you shine on me, Jesus? Ooh, I love the sun. I love you, Jesus.
I've always known he cared. Sometimes my heart cries out so loudly. Sometimes it seems he's just not there. I sometimes wonder how long until he wipes them dry. Is the nighttime almost over? Will joy come with the morning sky? And in the night I say a prayer. I feel a presence in the air. Sometimes it seems so far away. But from within I hear him say,
Every prayer.